If you look up an image of the Earth and Moon, but in reality, the Earth and Moon are about that far apart. That is the Earth and the Moon to scale. Taking the same concept, but put the orbits to scale on a piece of paper, the planets become microscopic, and you won't be able to see them. It actually looks like from out there. The only way to see a scale model of the solar system is to build one.
Welcome to Black Rock Desert. This is Alex.
Hi.
Wiley. He's going to be behind the camera. I'm going to be probably making a lot of mistakes on camera.
We have 36 hours to measure the distances, trace out the orbits, and set up a time-lapse shot from up on top of a nearby mountain. To create a scale model with an Earth only as big as this marble, you need 7 miles of empty space.
So that's why we're here.
Why did you guys come?
I don't have a job.
At this scale, the sun is a meter and a half, so about that big around.
So we are driving right now to Mercury, and we've arrived. Venus is the same size as Earth. I have the world in my pocket somewhere. And Earth. And this is Mars. Got a couple of robots rolling around on that one.
Once the time-lapse is ready, we'll drive each orbit with a light. Hopefully, you'll be able to tell just how big they really are.
Onward to the outer planets. Jupiter.
That tiny light out there is our sun, just over a mile away.
The sun's way, way out there now. This is it. This is the edge of the solar system.
So right now, it's about 7 a.m. We just woke up right before the sun's about to rise. We are on the Earth's orbit. Wiley is over there holding our sun. Cue the dramatic sunrise music.
So if we've made our model correctly, your perspective from where Earth is on the model will match your perspective from standing on the real Earth. So if you look back at the sun, you will see that the model sun and the real sun are the exact same size. And that's how you